हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, डियर स्टूडेंट्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज। ओके, नाउ इन टुडेज क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज विच इज ट्रायंगल एंड इट्स प्रॉपर्टी। ओके डियर स्टूडेंट, यू नो दैट वेरी वेल कि वी डिस्कस we solve all the questions, all that type of question of your NCERT exercise. Okay, now we discuss some important concept and we discuss some questions based on the triangle and its property. So look, first of all we discuss what is the angle. Before that, first we discuss about the some concept related to lines and angles. You know that very well ki lines, any lines is a special type of line segment which extended in both the direction, and angles, you know that if any ray rotate in anti-clockwise direction or clockwise direction from its initial position, then they form an angle. Means suppose that OA is a ray and they rotate in anti-clockwise direction and its final position is B, then that angle form an angle theta. Okay, that is called, this is known as angle AOB. Okay, dear friends, now in that chapter means angle, triangle and its property. So first of all we discuss about the triangle and types of triangles, and now the some important properties related to triangle. Okay, because of which is very important of you and your examination. Okay, so first of all we discuss about what is the concept of triangle. Dear students, you know that very well ki triangle is a region bounded by three line segment. Okay, so we can say that the region bounded by three line segment is called a triangle. Okay, thus in this way we can say that a region bounded by three line segments is called what? Triangle. Let's see this diagram. So suppose that here three line segments are AB, BC and AC. In that figure, in the given figure, the three line segments are what? AB, okay, BC and AC. Okay dear students, this is AB, BC and CA. So in this way we can say that, dear students, a region bounded by three line segments is called a triangle. Okay, so that region is known as a form of a triangle. Now, and dear students, you know that in previous class we discussed the chapter perimeter and area. Okay, and in that chapter we also discussed the concept of related to triangle, means we discuss about the perimeter and area of the triangle. This is suppose that in that triangle, what is the perimeter? Just I discuss about that, dear friend. In any geometrical figure, the sum of its all sides. So if we ask the what is the perimeter of that triangle, okay, then you says that the perimeter is that triangle sum of its all sides, means AB, BC plus CA. This is the concept of what perimeter, means the perimeter of the triangle is what? AB plus BC plus CA. This is the concept of the perimeter of the triangle. Okay dear students, now so this is the concept of the perimeter of any triangle, means AB, BC and CA. Okay, now what I do, if I ask you what is the area of that triangle, dear friend, you know that the general formula for the area of triangle is what? 1 upon 2 base into height. If we suppose that we draw AL perpendicular to BC, suppose that AL perpendicular to BC. If AL perpendicular to BC, then area of that triangle is what? 1 upon 2, base is what? BC into height is what? AL. This formula is also discussed in the previous class. Okay? So these are some important concepts related to triangle. One important thing is that your triangle has three angles. A triangle has three sides, three angles, and three vertices. Okay, three sides, three angles, and three vertices. So these are very important information related to triangle, dear students. Okay, now dear students, we discuss the exterior angle property of the triangle. Then after we discuss about the angle sum property of the triangle, and we take and solve some important question based on of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Let's see. Now we discuss exterior angle property of the look. Now we are going to discuss a very important property, that is exterior angle property of the triangle. Dear students, first of all, we discuss what is the concept of exterior angle. So let's see from the diagram. What is the concept of exterior angle? Let's see. Suppose that here ABC is a triangle. Suppose that we have a triangle ABC. Okay? If one side of that triangle, suppose that we extend the side BC. Suppose we produce the side BC 2D. Then that angle ACD is known as the exterior angle of that triangle. This is known as what? Exterior angle. Means angle ACD. Okay, if this one we produce the side AB of the triangle to E. Suppose that if we produce the side AB through E, then angle CBE is also known as what, dear friend? Exterior angle. Okay, if the side BE of the triangle produced to, suppose A, B, C, D, E, F, produced to F, then the angle CAF, that angle CAF is known as what? Exterior angles. Okay, similarly, if you produce the side CA, then they form the exterior angle. So, dear students, we can say that the concept of exterior angle is if one side of a triangle is extended, then they form a exterior angle. Okay, and according to very important property of the exterior angle means AL. It is a very important result, dear friends. The exterior angle of a triangle. Okay, dear students. The exterior angle of a triangle is always equal to the sum of its two
opposite anterior angles.
Okay, dear students. Thus, in this way, we can say that a very important result based on the exterior angle, ki means the exterior angle
of a triangle.
Okay, dear students. The exterior angle of a triangle is always equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angles. So, thus, from figure,
if we take the exterior angle ACD, dear students, just I discussed about that, if the exterior angle of a triangle is always equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angles. Okay, dear student, in the respect of exterior angle ACD, the two opposite interior angles is angle A and angle B. Okay, so here the exterior angle of the triangle is always equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angle means angle A plus angle B. Okay, now In the respect of exterior angle CBE, the two opposite interior angles are angle A, angle C. If you write exterior angle CBE, then this is also equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angle means angle A as well as angle C. So in this way, these are the very important result based on the exterior angle property of the triangle. So dear student, first of all, you do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay, so please do more and more practices of that type of results, questions, and solving the problem of your NCERT exercise. Okay, so these are the very important concept. Okay, now dear students, now we take and solve some important questions of your NCERT exercise based on that property. Let's see. Let's see. Suppose that we take a question. Find the value of x. Find the value of x in each of the following figures. And your figures is, first is what? This is A, B, C, this is 60, this is, okay, and second part of this question is what? Second part is, these are the question here. Let's see its solution. Dear student, in that question, what we find the value of the variable x. Now, in that figure, dear student, we apply the exterior angle property of the triangle because of that question. That problem is to be solved by the help of the exterior angle property. Okay. So here, just I discuss about the exterior angle property for a triangle. So we take we apply the exterior angle property of the triangle and we simplify that question. Let's see, dear students. Look, we saw take and solve the first part of this question. we know that what exterior angle is always equal to the sum of its opposite interior angles na. So here in that figure, look right in this way, from figure exterior angles AC, suppose that line segment produced to D. So exterior angle ACD is equal to, in that angle equal to sum of its two opposite interior angle, means what? Angle A plus angle B. Because of just I discussed about that property, he means the exterior angle is always equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angles. So here now, that is exterior angle ACD is equal to the value of A is x, the value of B is what? 60. And now we put the value of the exterior angle, which is what? 130. So here we put 130 is equal to x plus 60. So the value of x, we transfer that side. So 130 minus 60 is what? 70 degrees. Thus the value of the variable x is what? 70 degrees. So this is the solution of the given question. Dear students, similarly we take and solve the second part of this question. Let's see. Now from, we take the second question from figure, apply the exterior angles property. Here and for that figure also we apply the exterior angle property. Let's see what is the property. Suppose that line is produced to be just an exterior angle ACD also equal to sum of its two opposite interior angles, angle A plus angle B. Okay, now we put each and every value. Angle exterior angle AC is what? X. So here we put X is equal to angle A is what? 60 plus angle B is what? 45. Thus dear student, the value of variable X is what? This is 5, 6, 4, 10, 105 degrees. This is our required answer. Thus dear student, in this way we clear the concept of exterior angles. Now dear student, you revise all the topic that chapter which we discuss in that class. Just I discuss about the exterior angle property, then you solve each and every questions of your NCERT exam based on exterior angle property of for a triangle. Now dear students, we take and discuss the other important property which is what? Angle sum property of the triangle. Then after we take some questions based on that topic. Let's see. Now we take a very important property, which is what? Angle sum property of the triangle. Angle sum property of a triangle. Okay, suppose that ABC is a triangle. Okay, now look, according to this property, the all interior angles of triangle ABC, according to this property, the sum of, dear students, according to this property, the sum of all Indian angles of triangle ABC is always equal to 180 degrees. Okay, dear students,
this is one of the most important property for a triangle. So we, in this way, we can say that according to this property, the sum of all interior angles of a triangle ABC is always equal to 180 degrees. All is always equal to what, dear friends? 180 degrees. Thus,
in triangle ABC, we have what? This is angle A here, and this is interior angle B, this is interior angle C. Means angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degrees. Okay, dear students.
So in this way, we can say that this is a very important result. And this student, in your NCERT exercise, there are so many questions. There are so many questions based on that property of a triangle. Okay. Now here we take and solve some important questions of your NCERT exercise based on that properties. Let's see. Now we take a question. Find the value of x. Find x in each of the following figures. First one is what? Suppose that here we take ABC is a triangle. Okay, ABC is a triangle in which x, this is 45, this is 80. Now, in second part of this question is what? ABC, this is x, this is x, this is x. Okay. And in third part of this question is x and 45. Look, this is the question here, dear students. Okay,
this is 16.
Okay, look, this is the question here. So in each of the following figure, we find the value of x. Okay, dear friends. So now here, now what I do, dear friends? Now for that questions, we apply the angle sum property. Now we first of all we take the first part of this question. In that question, from figure we have the sum of angle of the property, the sum of all interior angle of a triangle is what? 180.
For then we have angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to what? 180, na? So we get as angle A is what? X. Angle B is what? 60. Angle C is what? 80 is equal to 180. So we get what? X plus 140 is equal to 180. Thus the value of x is what? 180 minus 140. Thus the value of a 180 minus 140 is what? 40 degrees. Thus in this way,
according to the angle sum property of a triangle, according to which property? According to angle sum property of our triangle, we get the value of x as what? 40. So this is our required solution of the given question. Similarly, dear students, we take and solve the second part of this question. Let's see the second part of this question, which is what? For triangle in, from figure, we have, what we have, let's say, एंगल ए प्लस एंगल बी प्लस एंगल सी इज इक्वल टू व्हाट डियर स्टूडेंट 180 डिग्री ना. नाउ हियर एंगल ए ईच एंगल ए बी एंड सी इज इक्वल टू व्हाट एक्स ना. सो हियर वी पुट व्हाट एक्स प्लस एक्स इज इक्वल टू व्हाट 180. Thus we get what x plus is what 3x is what equal to 180. Thus the value of x is what dear friends 180 upon 3 6 is 80 0. Thus the value of x is what 60 degree. This is our required solution on the given question. Okay. Now similarly we take and solve the third part of this question. Let's see. In third part dear friends is what from figure. Again here we apply the angle sum property for a triangle. For that figure we also apply the angle sum property. So we get what from figure? We have angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180. Thus we get angle A is what 40. This is x is equal to 180. That is 2x is equal to x or x what? This is 2x now. And we transfer that side to 180 minus 40. So we get 2x is equal to 180 minus 40 is what? 140 degree. Thus the value of x is what? 140 degree upon 2. This 270. Thus 70 degree. This is our required solution of the given questions. Okay, dear student. Thus, dear students, in this way, today's class we discuss all the important property related to all the important property related to triangle. Means in we discuss about the angle sum property of the triangle and also we discuss the angle sum property for a triangle. Now dear students, we clear the concept of some important facts related to right angle triangle and one important theorem related to that, which is Pythagoras theorem, Pythagoras property. Let's see.
Which is your in syllabus. Okay.
Now we just discuss about that topic, and now in next class we take and solve the some other important some question based on that topic. Okay.
Now just we discuss a right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. Dear students, in any one. If one of the angle is equal to 90 degree, in any triangle ABC, if one angle is equal to 90 degree, then it is said to be a right angle triangle. In that triangle, for that triangle, here angle C is equal to what? 90 degree, na? The straight angle, the right perpendicular. So that angle, though that type of triangle is known as what? A right angle triangle.
So in this way, we can say that for any triangle ABC, if one of its angle is equal to 90 degree, then it is said to be a right angle triangle. Dear students, the one of the most important property related to right angle triangle is what? Pythagoras property.
Which property dear students? This is Pythagoras property. Dear students, for any right angle triangle, in any right angle triangle, this side BC is your base. BC is called base. AB is what? Your hypotenuse. Okay. And AC is what? Your perpendicular or height, or simply you can height. Okay. And
what is the concept of Pythagoras property for dear student? Pythagoras property is applicable, is valid for only a right angle triangle, not a equilateral triangle, not a escalene triangle, not a isosceles triangle. It is applicable or valid for only right angle triangle. Okay. So according to Pythagoras property, the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of its square of its base and its perpendicular. This is the one of the most property related to right angle for a right angle triangle. Which is means according to diagram we get as AB square, because AB is your hypotenuse, this is your base, this is your perpendicular. So hypotenuse is AB square is equal to what? BC square plus AC square. Now dear students, in this way today's class we discuss all the important concepts related to what? Related to triangle and its property. And we today's class we take and solve some other some important question based on exterior angle property and angles of property of the triangle, and we also discuss the right angle triangle and Pythagoras property. Now in next class we take this question, we take question based on the Pythagoras property and solve it. Okay dear students, now thanks to all.